Applicant indicates chute deployed.
The navigation has confirmed that the parachute has deployed, and we are seeing significant deceleration in the velocity. Our current velocity is 440 meters per second at an altitude of about 12 kilometers from the surface of Mars.
What if the next photo from Mars reveals something terrifying? The tale of NASA's Perseverance and Curiosity rovers is packed with stunning images that have changed what we know and guided future trips to Mars. The power of these 4K images is unlocking secrets about Mars, making us eager to dig deeper. But what if we're on the brink of discovering something unimaginable? Let's reveal what this could mean for our view of life beyond Earth, the new frontier in space exploration. The story covers the important progress made by the Perseverance and Curiosity rovers. It focuses on the outstanding photos they've taken, the new scientific knowledge gained from these images, and what this means for future missions to Mars. As the chapter closes, one haunting question remains. What if the next image from Perseverance uncovers something unthinkable hidden on Mars? The value of high-quality images in studying Mars is immense. Clear and detailed pictures of the Martian surface allow scientists to closely examine the planet's rocks, atmosphere, and any potential signs of past life. The stunning 4K images and videos from Perseverance and Curiosity are vital in this work, opening new doors to understanding the planet. The data collected by these rovers continue to offer groundbreaking insights, helping to guide future explorations of Mars. This rover is packed with the latest scientific tools and is on a mission to explore Mars's dusty surface for signs of ancient life. It also collects rock and soil samples to bring back to Earth and test new technologies that will be important for sending astronauts to Mars someday. The cameras can zoom in, helping to spot interesting rocks and features from a distance, making it easier to decide where Perseverance should travel next to take a closer look or gather samples. People could watch as the spacecraft plunged through Mars's thin atmosphere, the parachute opened to slow it down, and the rover finally touched down in the Jezero crater. This video gave us an amazing, never-before-seen glimpse into the challenges of landing on another planet. Since it landed, the Perseverance rover has been busy, capturing detailed photos of the area around it. These images, taken by the Mastcam Z, show large stretches of Mars's surface, from the edges of craters to scattered rocks. Perseverance also takes selfies using the Watson camera on its robotic arm. These photos are important for engineers to check the rover's condition and help make the space mission feel more real and exciting for people on Earth. At the same time, the Curiosity rover has been preparing the way for Perseverance ever since it arrived on Mars on August 6, 2012. While Curiosity's cameras don't produce super high-definition images, they have still captured amazing and detailed views of the Martian surface. This is especially true in the Gale Crater area, where it has been exploring different types of terrain and providing valuable insights that have helped guide the missions that came after. Curiosity's Mastcam, though not as advanced as Perseverance's Mastcam Z, is still incredibly important for capturing clear, high-quality photos of Mars. This camera has taken countless pictures, including detailed images of Mount Sharp, the central peak in Gale Crater. These photos are essential for scientists who study the mountain's layers, revealing evidence of ancient lakes and streams that once flowed on Mars. Let's take a closer look at Mars through the eyes of the rovers. A rover's exploration through time. As Curiosity climbs Mount Sharp, it sends back even more interesting photos of the Martian landscape. With each meter it ascends, the rover moves through different layers of sediment, with each one telling a story about Mars's history. The photos show clear signs of water erosion and clay deposits, which suggest that water was once abundant in this area. This information is key to understanding how water once moved on Mars and gives clues about the planet's past environment, which may have supported life. Even though Curiosity's main camera doesn't record in 4K, the images it captures are carefully enhanced to create impressive 4K videos. These videos, available online, offer a vivid and immersive experience of Mars, almost as if you're walking across the planet's diverse and rugged terrain alongside the rover. The detailed pictures taken by the rovers, Perseverance, and Curiosity have revealed some important discoveries that have deepened our understanding of Mars and its potential to support life. One significant discovery by Perseverance is the finding of rocks that seem to have been shaped by ancient lava flows that later interacted with water. This is crucial for understanding Mars's geological history, suggesting that Mars once had a more active and possibly life-friendly environment long ago. Both rovers, Perseverance and Curiosity, have found organic compounds in Martian rocks. These compounds are the building blocks of life, hinting that Mars might have had conditions suitable for life in the past. The sharp images have allowed scientists to pinpoint exactly where these compounds are, guiding further research and the collection of samples for study. But the most exciting part is that this ongoing research might uncover even more about whether Mars once supported life and how its environment has changed over millions of years. The photos taken by the rovers Perseverance and Curiosity have shown clear signs that water once flowed on Mars. In places like Jezero Crater, Perseverance has found smooth rocks that likely formed in water. These rocks have streaks of sulfate which appear when water moves through cracks in rocks and leaves minerals behind. This discovery suggests that Mars once had a much wetter environment, one that could have supported life. Moreover, the sharp images from Perseverance are crucial for the upcoming Mars sample return mission. This important project aims to bring Martian rock and soil samples back to Earth for a closer look. The detailed photos help scientists choose the best samples to collect, ensuring the mission gathers the most valuable information. Bringing these samples back will be a key step in understanding Mars's past and whether it could have supported life. Looking ahead, the successes of Perseverance and Curiosity are just the beginning of what promises to be an exciting time for studying Mars. NASA has big plans for the coming years, with many bold missions that will build on the discoveries made by these rovers. One of NASA's top goals is to send humans to Mars. The information gathered by Perseverance and Curiosity is essential in planning these missions, as it helps scientists and engineers understand the Martian surface and conditions. But that's not all. High-resolution images will continue to play a crucial role. These images will help create accurate maps for landing, identify where resources can be found for astronauts, and offer a detailed view of what Mars is really like. Now we explore how we might live on Mars in the future. Utilizing the Red Planet's resources. As we look ahead to future trips to Mars, a big focus is on using the planet's own resources to support human life. This idea, called in-situ resource utilization, means we'll rely on Mars's materials for our needs. Scientists are working on ways to extract water from the Martian soil, turn the planet's carbon dioxide-filled air into oxygen, and create building materials from the rocks and minerals found there. Detailed images of Mars will help identify the best locations for these activities, guiding the development of technology that could allow people to live on Mars for long periods. Exploring Mars isn't just a job for NASA, it's a global effort. Space agencies from all over the world, like the European Space Agency and Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, are also focused on Mars. These international missions will support NASA's work, with a strong emphasis on cooperation and sharing information. The sharp, detailed photos sent back by rovers like Perseverance and Curiosity play a key role. They help coordinate international missions and deepen the scientific understanding we gain from Mars. NASA is also eager to get the public, especially young people, excited about space. By reaching out to the community and sharing the stories and discoveries from Mars, NASA hopes to spark a passion for space in the next generation of explorers and scientists. These efforts make the journey to Mars feel more connected to our lives here on Earth, and inspire more people to dream about exploring and understanding our neighboring planet. But that's not all. One of the most challenging parts is ensuring that we can actually survive on Mars long term. Scientists are working tirelessly to solve this problem, and every small step forward brings us closer to making it a reality. Our research suggests that bacteria or similar organisms either exist now or once existed on Mars. Even if they were more common in the distant past, the conditions on Mars don't seem to have wiped them out completely. It looks like Mars has supported life and might still be doing so. The debate over life on Mars has been going on for decades, which might explain why NASA has been cautious about making any official announcements. But let's take a closer look at some of the key findings we've gathered. The 1976 Viking mission marked a significant chapter in the exploration of Mars, distinguished by its primary objective to detect life on another planet. Among its suite of scientific experiments, the labeled Release Experiment stood out. This particular experiment employed a novel approach, avoiding the intricacies of more common methodologies. Instead, it aimed to identify microbial life by observing the metabolic processes that might occur in Martian soil. The results from this experiment fueled debates and discussions for years, as they presented ambiguous data that suggested the possible presence of living organisms. This mission remains a landmark in planetary exploration, highlighting the complexity and intrigue of searching for life beyond Earth. Next, we dive deeper into the signs of life on Mars. Signs of life beneath the surface. Since then, the Perseverance rover has found organic material in Martian soil. The Curiosity rover has also made some important discoveries. For example, it detected methane in the Martian atmosphere, with large amounts appearing only during the warm summer months. Typically, we'd see such spikes in methane if bacteria were active in the warmer temperatures. Another possible explanation could be geological processes, but these wouldn't change with the seasons or temperature, suggesting the methane might indeed be coming from living organisms. In addition to this, Curiosity found unusually high levels of oxygen in the Martian atmosphere, which hints that life could be a major source of this oxygen. It also discovered an unusually high concentration of manganese along an ancient Martian coastline. Normally, such high levels of manganese would likely be produced by biological processes. Recent tests have even shown that various life forms might survive just below the surface of Mars, possibly living a few centimeters deep in the soil for long periods. All these consistent findings strongly suggest that life might have existed or still exists on Mars. But this isn't the most surprising part. It challenges us to rethink what we know about life in the universe. For a long time, people have wondered if Mars might have some form of life, but we haven't done any serious tests to check this out since 1976. However, a new discovery on Mars has caught a lot of attention and adds to the growing evidence that life might be possible there. While this evidence alone doesn't prove anything, when you look at all the findings together, it becomes really hard to believe that life isn't there in some form. Recently, an interesting article from space.com talked about an exciting discovery by the Perseverance rover. The rover found a strangely shaped rock called Chava Falls, which looks a bit like an arrowhead. This rock has some chemical markers and formations that might have been created by tiny organisms billions of years ago when Mars was much wetter than it is now. When the rover examined the rock, it found organic compounds. These compounds are important because they are the building blocks of life as we know it. The rock also has streaks of calcium sulfate, a mineral that shows water was once present, a key ingredient for life, but that's not all. The rover also discovered many tiny spots, each about the size of a millimeter, surrounded by dark rings, making them look like leopard spots. These rings have iron and phosphate, which on Earth are often created by the chemical activities of tiny life forms. Continuing our search, we examine more clues about life on Mars. The quest for hidden life. David Flannery, an astrobiologist from the Queensland University of Technology in Australia and a member of the Perseverance science team, is excited about these spots. He pointed out that similar features in rocks on Earth are usually associated with the fossilized remains of microbes that lived below the surface. This suggests that we might be close to proving that microbial life once existed, or maybe still exists, beneath Mars's surface. While none of these discoveries on their own can definitively prove life on Mars, together they suggest a strong possibility that Mars once had, or still has, some form of life. The more we find, the more it seems likely that Mars was once full of conditions favorable for life. But that's not even the most surprising part. It also pushes us to keep searching for answers about life beyond Earth. This ongoing exploration of Mars not only helps us understand the planet better, but also keeps our curiosity alive as we search for life in the universe. The spots seen on sedimentary rocks on Earth sometimes happen when hematite causes the rock's color to change from red to white. This change also releases iron and phosphate, which might lead to the creation of dark circular marks. These reactions could provide energy for microbes, which might be why we often find these markings where microbes are active in similar Earth environments. However, it's important to remember that just because we see these features on rocks, it doesn't automatically mean there was ancient microbial life on Mars, at least not yet. For instance, the calcium sulfate found in these rocks might have come from high temperatures, possibly due to volcanic activity nearby. It's still unclear if these dark spots could have formed through purely chemical reactions without any biological involvement. What's particularly interesting is that these rocks are rich in organic compounds, which makes it seem more likely that life could have existed there. This idea that life might have been present seems more convincing than the idea of purely chemical explanations. Still, scientists are careful about jumping to conclusions regarding life on other planets. They often consider theories that suggest life might have spread across the solar system through meteorites, which could explain why similar bacteria types are found on different planets. But that's not the end of the story. Each new discovery adds another piece to the puzzle. Scientists are eager to keep searching for more clues. from finding methane to detecting oxygen, and from the Viking experiments to the discovery that Earth microbes could survive on Mars, the evidence is piling up. The many discoveries coming from Mars seem to tell us the same thing. Mars might not be as different from Earth as we once thought, especially when it comes to supporting life. As we learn more about Mars, the possibility of life there, and perhaps on other planets or moons, becomes even more intriguing. These distant worlds aren't just empty landscapes of rocks and ice, they might actually be homes to living organisms, whether they're similar to what we know or completely new forms we haven't imagined yet. The steady stream of data from Mars only deepens our understanding, making it clearer that our solar system might be more full of life than we used to think. But the story doesn't end there. With each discovery, we see more and more signs pointing to the possibility of life beyond Earth. As we delve deeper into the cosmos, do you think we are ready to meet extraterrestrial life? Like, comment your thoughts, and don't forget to subscribe for more.